What is Recuva? If you've ever accidentally deleted an important file from your computer, you know the frustration of wasted hours to recreate it. Recuva can recover deleted files from your Windows computer, the recycling bin, digital camera cards, MP3 players, and other removable media. Recuva is available for free. Let's download and install Recuva. Open a web browser like Internet Explorer. In the address bar, type in piriform.com/recuva, which is piriform.com/recuva, and then press enter. There will also be a direct link provided in the description. On the Recuva homepage, click the download button. On the Recuva download page, there are three download options. We are going to select the free version. Under where it says download from, we have two locations to download the file from. I think it's a little bit easier, so let's just click the piriform.com link. On the download information bar, click the run button. This will download the file and then automatically start the installer. Once the download finishes, it'll open the installer language window. Click the OK button. On the Recuva setup window, click the Next button. On the License Agreement screen, read the license agreement, and then click the I Agree button. On the Install Options window, leave the three default options selected, and then click the Install button. After a brief installation, the Completing the Recuva Setup Wizard screen will open. Deselect both options, and click the Finish button. We could have left it set to automatically start, but I wanted to show you the two ways you can go about starting the application. For this tutorial, we are going to recover deleted files from a USB thumb drive. The files you're looking to recover can be located on any kind of drive on your computer, or any removable media, like USB drives. Keep in mind during this tutorial that I'm going to be recovering from the USB drive, so you may need to vary your steps slightly to recover the files from wherever you have selected them. We'll click the Windows Start button, and then select Computer. Under the section labeled Devices with Removable Storage, we can see Removable Disk E. This is my USB drive. We'll double-click to open it. Here we can see two files listed. These are nothing more than test files that we will use for this tutorial. There's nothing in them that have the same name as the document. Let's go ahead and select both of these files, and then press the delete key. Then click yes to confirm deleting the files. If we just deleted this file from a folder on your computer, then it would go to the recycling bin. It wouldn't be completely deleted. But because we're using a USB drive, it just deletes the file without going to the recycling bin. At this point, if we realized that we really didn't want to delete these files, and we had deleted them from somewhere on the physical computer, not on the USB drive, then we could double-click on the recycling bin and restore the files from here. Now that we have deleted our file, our only option to get the file back is to use a deleted file recovery program. There are two ways you can go about opening a Recuva. Option 1. You can double-click on the Recuva icon on the desktop. Option 2, you can click the Windows Start button, All Programs, Recuva, and then select Recuva. The Welcome to the Recuva Wizard screen will open. You can use the wizard if you like, but we're going to skip that and go directly into the application by clicking the Cancel button. This is the Recuva application window. At the very top, it gives you some basic information, such as the version, which in this case is 1.42, and that it's 64-bit. Below this, we can see basic Windows information, showing that this is Windows 7 Home Premium, 64-bit, with Service Pack 1. It also provides some basic hardware information about your computer. In this case, we can see that this system has an AMD FX8120 8-core processor, has 8GB of RAM, and it has a Radeon HD 4800 series. Under all this information on the toolbar, on the left-hand side, it has a drop-down menu with the drives and other media listed. If we click this drop-down menu, we can see that there are options for local disk C and storage X, which are both physical hard drives in this computer. Your computer may only have one, and it will most likely be the C drive. The names will also probably be different. In between these, we can see our USB drive listed as removable disk E. At the very bottom, we can see all drives listed. By selecting all drives, it'll tell the program to scan all drives in the system. This will take the longest, but if you have no idea where the file is located, this is the option you want to select. We're going to select the USB drive by selecting Removable Disk E. By default, Recuva runs a quick scan. But if that doesn't find the file, you can enable a deep scan. To run a quick scan, to the right of the USB drive that we have selected, let's click the Scan button. Here we can see the three deleted files along with the corresponding path or location that they were deleted from, which in this case is all the E drive. If you look to the left of each file, you'll see a circle which is green for all of these. This indicates that the file is all there and will be able to be recovered. If the files are partially damaged, they may show up as yellow, with only parts of them being recoverable. And if they're red, the file is probably so damaged that you won't be able to recover it at all. If the quick scan didn't find anything, you should enable deep scan and then scan again. To do this, we need to click the Options button. Click the Actions tab. Under Scanning, click to select Deep Scan. And then click the OK button. Now that the deep scan is enabled, we need to click the Scan button again. We'll see the scan window pop up. It'll show the current stage, the progress of how far it's gone through, the number of files found, and the estimated time remaining. This is only a 16GB USB drive, so it should take about 10 minutes. But if you were to scan your entire hard drive on your computer, it could take a half hour or longer. We were able to find the files before with a quick scan, so I'm just going to cancel this. Now that we've found our files, let's restore them. If you scanned an entire hard drive, it's possible this list may have thousands of files. There is a search field provided so that you can narrow down the list by name. Let's click to select each of these files that we want to recover. We just need to keep in mind that they'll all be restored to the same directory and not back to where they were originally deleted from. Let's click the Recover button. The Browse for Folder window will open. Now we could restore this back to the USB drive, but the software manufacturer recommends that you don't restore back to the same location that you're recovering the file from. You can choose wherever you want, but I'm going to restore this file to the X drive in the test folder. Once selected, click the OK button. On the Operation Completed window, we can see that it recovered three files. Click the OK button. Now let's browse through the directory where we restored our files. And here we can see our files. Now we can leave these here or move these back to the USB drive. You should now have the necessary information to recover a deleted file from your computer.